Hey everyone, I had another request for section 5. So, I'm gonna make another video. I'm just gonna take you through the whole maze to the outer rim. And then we'll go to section 5. It makes it easier to learn that way. Okay, so we're gonna head to the maze. If you go into settings and choose your foliage amount and set it to the highest, it makes it a little bit easier to remember how to get through the maze. Because then you have all the greenery on the walls and the rocks and just more things to remember how to get through. Like having landmarks. So you have all these rocks here. You stay all the way to the left. The walls have texture. It seems confusing, but you eventually remember the way. Definitely keep the foliage set at high. It doesn't take long though, it's only about a few minutes to get through the maze to the outer rim. We're already here. These two narrow straightaways you go through, it's right before you leave the maze. There's two of them, they're identical. This at the end changes sometimes. I don't know why, it's different. But it's right by the outer rim, so you could still find your way. It took a little bit of a long time. And here we are at the outer rim. Section 5 is nice because it's close. As soon as you leave the maze, it's right here. So we see this ramp up ahead. You could take the steps too, to the right, but I just find it quicker to go up the ramp. Just don't fall and miss this platform because then you have to start over and go back up the ramp again. Just a little annoying. And then what we do is we make the first left. After you make your left, you stay to the left here, and we're here already. Here's section 5. Section 5, well, the sections have a yellow and black tape on the walls, and that'll help you too to remember to go left, to go right, where to turn. When we first go in, we stay to the right. Just a little bit. We're gonna make our first right. You can see the PI on the wall. You can use that as another landmark. Okay, here's our first right. Left. Another you just follow your way through. Can't go left or right. So. You can only go one way. And we're almost there. And the gate is right up ahead there. And here we are. And once you go through this, then we are at the Blades. It takes about 10 minutes to escape, at least for section 5. It seems to take about 10 to 12 minutes for every section. Run up until we get to the actual Blades. Right up ahead on the left. And then once you get to the Blades right here, then you want to just keep staying to your left. Stay to the left. You just cut through and go diagonal most of the way. No exact route right here, you just want to. And then we make a left, and we are here. We're at the bridge. When you get here, the walls will open for you to get to the. Have to put the code in. Here we are. If you get too close to it, it takes a long time to give you the keypad for the code. So back up a little bit. And it's 715-26483. The code is always the same every time. Just like in the movie. Okay, we did it. Now we just wait for the door to open. It seems like it takes forever, but it opens. Okay, we go through there. And then it'll take you to this narrow hallway. And you make your way right. If you go left, it's just a wall. Nothing there. Then when we're gonna get to the second door, you wanna put out your torch. I don't know why, but it doesn't work with the torch on. And then you tap the door, just touch the door, or click on the handle, and this one will open. If you don't, it won't. And that'll take us to this room. Where all this bad stuff happened to these scientists. It's a little bit sad, but I am always happy to escape. Sometimes I stop and look around. And to your left, it tells you a lot about the maze. There's descriptions and pictures of each section. Mostly, we just want to go towards that bright light and escape. And we're out. To get to runner, you need 45 escapes, 3 cliff jumps, and 1 griever kill.